Hi guys, this is MJ. Welcome back to my channel. I wanted to do something super fun and cute and like So what you just saw is the effects of me falling on the ice outside the house last night and waking up this morning feeling like someone had tried to kill me. Yeah, so I came home early from work. I spent about 4.5 hours lying on a heating pack swearing. But I've been putting off filming this video because I wanted it to be perfect. And I wanted it to be perfect for so long that I fucked it all up because now it's late and I'm hurt and just everything. So I figured instead of perfect, we're gonna go with real. So I'm a little bit on the stiff side. I'm a little uncomfortable. I'm probably gonna have to take frequent hot chocolate and ibuprofen breaks, but we're gonna film this and it's gonna be amazing. So this isn't really a haul video so much as it is things I have collected over the last couple of weeks that I've tried out. I wanted to share with you and see if you liked them because I liked them. And let's just start with the beginning, I guess. Starting with the beginning, I'm gonna mention these two products. They're both masks. One of them is a real mask. One is like a moisturizing mask. This is the Previ Aqua Gel Mask. I got this in an Ipsy. I am in love with it. I absolutely have to order like my own full size. I don't even care. Like it could be $100 and it's amazing. It has, one, it smells like rosemary and awesomeness. Two, these itty bitty bits of gel in there will last you like forevers and it's phenomenal. And it says that you can rinse it off afterwards or you can leave it on. I have been leaving it on and my skin is looking so good compared, other than like a couple like little hormonal spots, which I'm never gonna get away from. My skin is soft, the texture looks better, it just looks great. Like I'm really impressed with the product. The other is the e.l.f. Hydrating Bubble Mask. This is, it's neat. It's not a holy grail for me though. Like, you take off the thing and you pump it and it comes out with the little stuff and then you put the stuff on your face and then it bubbles up and it tickles really bad. Like within like a few minutes, I was like, I don't like this. I don't like this. I don't like this. Oh, I don't like this. Okay, wash it off. So it says you're supposed to leave it on for like 15, 20 minutes. And like I'm itching thinking about it. I could only do about 5 minutes before the sensation of the bubble mask drove me up a wall and I had to take it off like right away. I was like, nope, can't do this. Get rid of it. Get rid of it right now. I've recently picked up a bunch of new like face products because I'm trying to try some different stuff out. Two of them are both the Fit Me by Maybelline. I know these aren't new, but they're new for me. They're stick foundations. I got Classic Ivory and Porcelain because I am a special little snowflake. And they are the right combination of just the base for me, which is the ivory, and then highlighting a little bit under the eyes, which is the porcelain. Really smooth, really soft. They have a powder core, which I mean, whatever, it's a powder core. Lots of things have that. That doesn't make any difference to me, but I like how they last on my skin and they tend to feel really nice long-term. And I did pick up this amazing, this is the Ultimate Blending Brush from e.l.f. Look at the top of it, this like pretty little dome. Isn't that neat? So it's super like dense and it's got the perfect like texture. I was doing my mom's makeup last night. It just feels so good on your skin. Like it's just, I'm a big fan of this and I will probably be going over to Target when I don't feel like shit and buying like 3 more of them because it's just, I consider this a ride or die staple brush comparatively with all the other brushes that I have. And like, I've got brushes for days and this brush, this $4 brush is my ride or die brush now because I'm in love with it. Now, I did talk in my last haul video, which was my drugstore haul, about the Wet n Wild cushions. This is another one that I found. I'm gonna see if I actually can just get all of them because I really do enjoy them now that I've used them more. And this is the lavender. It's the brightening. I don't know if you can see. It's a fairly pigmented lavender, but it blends out really smooth. It does do its job as color correcting. This one's for brightening. With the fancy brush, it's got this like super soft, light as air texture to it, and it blends out really nicely. I think if you were much darker than me, I don't think you could wear it comfortably, but if you are the same shade as me, or a little bit lighter than me, or maybe even a little bit darker than me, then you would probably be okay for as far as color-wise. Wet n Wild has been coming out with some more varied color shades, but I'm not going to speak on behalf of people of color, because I'm not one. Another not new, but new for me, is this Almay Color Smart Shade CC Cream. It's a complexion corrector. It is kind of watery, like right there. You gotta shake it up a little bit to get some product out, but it's got this really nice, like soft, blendable texture to it. It's great for like everyday wear when you don't wanna have something super heavy on. Like if I'm not feeling awesome, that's kind of the one that I reach for because I just want something light, or if I'm just go to the post office on my day off and I want a little bit of coverage, but I don't really want to cake everything on and go glam. That's generally the first one that I reach for of the last like month or two. And this, which is from Ulta Beauty, it's one of their new ones. They seem to be refreshing a lot of their products. This is the HD Soft Focus Liquid Foundation. I bought it in light cool and I bought it in medium warm because my mom is a little bit more of a warm tone skin than I am. Both of these, their pump, which I love, really super soft. It says like it's kind of marketed for like sheer coverage, but I find like a pretty moderate, like medium coverage more so than sheer coverage. It's just, and it's got a great texture to it. I've applied it with my fingers, I've applied it with the brush, I've applied it with a beauty blender, and all of them have the same texture. I first tried it because I popped it on my hand in the store, and then I was walking around and I hadn't put it in my cart yet, and I looked down and I was like, oh shit, that looks really good. I should maybe go back and buy that. And I went out and I bought it, and I liked it so much for myself that I went and I bought a second one for my mom when I do her makeup, and for Sammy because she has similar tones as my mom. And I just really, big fan, big fan. Last face product is the new Cheeky Tints from Hard Candy. They have a bunch of like blushes and stuff like this. This is a sheer blush gel. A water-like gel blush that has all the day staying power, incredibly easy to blend, mistake-proof formula, and gives a sheer wash of color for a true natural flush. Apply to cheeks using fingertips. I bought this one, which actually I think might have been listed as a bronzer, but I like brownish blushes. It comes out like that from the tube, and then it is a water base, so you can blend it. You have to blend fast though, it does dry really quick. So if you don't get in there and blend it out, then you'll have harsh lines. Like even now, after putting it on my hand for literally seconds ago, it's already at a point where it's like tacky and I can't blend it at all anymore. But it lasts all freaking day. This is the shade 1090 Goddess. This is slowly becoming one of my gotta have it's for like day-to-day makeup. Big fan. One mascara that's new to the bunch. I have stopped trying out a lot of new mascaras, I guess. I like my Lash Blast. I like my Doll Eyes from Physicians Formula. I love Superhero from It. And I like them enough that I just don't buy a lot of mascara. I don't wear falsies a lot though, so good mascara really does count. This is by e.l.f. It is, I don't know exactly which one this is. It's, what do you have here? 93001 Naked Noir. Here's why I got it. Look at this teeny tiny little brush. For like bottom lashes or separating your lashes, I've never found one that has as tiny of a brush and is as accurate of a brush. And the formula is nice too. It's very light. It's like a tint. Okay. It's the Beautifully Bare Lash Tint Mascara. I always try to keep my packaging. I have a little table for it that I keep my packaging on. But it's got a tint, so it will stay a little bit longer. It is water resistant, I found. Big fan of this. This is e.l.f. And so you're paying like $2 for it. So why not try it? So I had to go to Sephora with a gift card and to exchange some stuff that I had ordered online. It just was not. One I ordered online, I already had it. And the other one I ordered online, it was not what I wanted at all. But I did get a new Makeup Forever trio. I got this beautiful pearly pink and gold color, a metallic pumpkin orange. This diamond white I already had. I like that you can mix and match their palettes a little bit. And I also got a really pretty metallic navy. I love their pigments. Like finger swatch, wabam, wabam, finger swatch, wabam, double wabam. Like they're gel powder formulas and you're never gonna find anything more amazing than those. And I'm just, and they're stuck to me. They're stuck to me because they're awesome. Like that's why they're stuck to me. But that's legit like something I'm happy to spend $44 on for three eyeshadows, because for $44 for three eyeshadows where I know I could buy a palette for $44. Topaz. Really, dude? Yeah? Actually? Really? You don't say. As I said in the room tour, peanut gallery. So while I don't mind spending $44 on three eyeshadows where I know I could get a whole palette, even I could get a whole palette from them, quality-wise, like you really just can't beat the quality of their shadows. And the pan sizes are huge too. Like you're getting a pretty decent sized product. The heat just came on and Topaz thinks that the heat is his special friend and he is serenading the heat. The heat and him are the buddies. Another palette I picked up at the grocery store. And I think I sent this one or something similar to it to Typhoid Holly on my last giveaway. By the way, I'm doing a giveaway. Go back to the video. It says golden giveaway. Golden giveaway. Because I'm giving away a whole shit ton of eyeshadows. And I kind of, ow. Tweaked. I did a thing. I think the world is mad at me for swearing. I have a potty mouth. I'm sorry. Let's try that again. The LA Colors 16 eyeshadow. Ow! The LA Colors 16 eyeshadow palette in 74202 Hot. It is their pastel and neon, and everything in here is sparkly. Little tiny bit of kickback, a decent amount of fallout, but also like heavily pigmented. So like I've been using this pink a lot. Bam. Bam. I mean, you pay $6 for these palettes. You really just can't go wrong for a $6 palette if you want to start playing with the brights a little bit. So I would recommend them. I used this on my friend last night after I fell when I was sitting there like, no, I'm fine. Everything's fine. No, nothing's wrong. No, it's fine. It's fine. It's not fucking fine. I hurt so fucking bad. Oh, I'm gonna get kicked off of YouTube. I'm not gonna get ad sponsors because of my swearing, but it hurts. Okay, back to the eyeshadow, because eyeshadow fixes everything. This guy, $4 or $5, LA Colors, Amazeballs, pastel colors. I have all of theirs by now, I think. I really enjoy them. So when I was at Sephora, I spent some monies, and it was worth it. I want you to not judge me before I show you what I bought. And I'm gonna even show you what I bought with a backdrop that I bought because I was inspired by the thing that I bought. Whoa! I'm so ready! This is the Kat Von D Alchemist palette. And it is, look at it, look at it. Look how shiny, shiny, shiny it is. This is the one she supposedly spent years and years developing, and it's duochrome, and it's face and eye highlight palette, and you don't get a ton of product. Like, you don't. You get 4 eyeshadow pans that are 0.05 ounces, and I hope it's not limited edition, because I will have to buy 3 or 4 of them, but look at it. These look super pastel. They look like there's like no anything about them, but I'm gonna be right back and I'm gonna show you why these have stolen my heart. So on their own, these 4 shadows are called Green Emerald, Blue Sapphire, Ultraviolet Amethyst, and Pink Opal. And They don't look like much. And even when you just, like, if I just take a swatch of ultraviolet and put it on my cheek, like, you can see there's some, like, glowiness. Like, I have some right here. But it's not like, oh my god, it's amazing, it's amazing, it's amazing. But on my hand, I'm going to show you that I've swatched it on both a white primer and a black primer. Look at the sparkle. Look at the sparkle. Oh my god. And here's it with like nothing under. There's a pink one with nothing underneath it. But it's just for like inner corner highlights or on the face highlights or anything. It just is beautiful. It's so pretty. It's like $33. I 100% did not have any buyer's remorse. If any of you know me, I am someone who like, I purchase something and I'm like, oh god, that was a lot of money. What have I done? I can't eat for the rest of this week. I didn't do that. I got in my car. Excuse me. I got in the car. I'm on like the drive home and I'm looking at the bag like, oh, hey. Hey, I can't wait to get you back to my place. Oh, hey, Sephora bag. And I played with it and I wore it days and days and days until I was like, no, I'm going to hit pan. And I got scared because I love it so much that I almost don't want to use it, but I want to use it with everything. So this is the Kat Von D Alchemist palette. It's so pretty. It's beautiful. And the packaging is this white, holographic, iridescent, just... It's so pretty. So pretty. Ow! Damn it! Whatever I tweaked in my neck is straight up punishing me for enjoyment. So, let's move on to lips. I have 5 lip products to go over with you guys. The first one I'm wearing right now, this is Too Faced Lip Injection Extreme. It's an instant and long-term lip plumper. It's all I have on right now, and I will agree with it that it is extreme. Disclosure. It burns like a son of a bee when you first put it on for about 5 minutes. And then you can feel like a slight tingling, but you definitely notice the plumpiness of your lips. But it doesn't hurt. It's uncomfortable for some time. But I've been putting this, I've exfoliated, which makes it burn worse. Exfoliate, put it on underneath, let it sink in, and then put my lip color over the top, because plumping stretches your lips out because it fills them up and then you have less lines. And then everything works better. And 2 of the colors I have used with it, all the colors actually I'm going to show you I have used with it, are also by Hard Candy. These are Genius and Famous out of their Wet Ever liquid lipsticks. These are super long lasting. I love the little tins that they come in. Like, their packaging for a drugstore brand is A+. So they come in this little tin. It's got a little mirror, and it's actually like hardcore. Like, that's an awesome mirror, and you can see my filming stand in it. Ooh. And then it has this matte black with this raised up slick wet, and that's the color. So whatever color, like, what is this? This is Genius. So whatever the color is on the box is the color that's in the tube, and exactly the color that, hold up, I'll prove it, goes on your lips. Like, it's just, and it's got a nice formula. It's soft. It's not sticky feeling. It is, I'm enjoying it. It feels like a gloss, but it has the staying power of a liquid lipstick. Similar to Melted, similar to L'Oreal Infallible Lip Paints. I like this formula. This is a formula that I'm going to be purchasing more of. And I got 2 of like kind of neutrally reds so I could try it out. But I'm definitely going to purchase some more of them because I really enjoyed it. And they had a beautiful dark, 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 dark purple, which is totally my color. These next 2 colors are from MAC. I'm going to give a shout out to Tim at the MAC in Manchester, New Hampshire. He did an amazing job showing me things, showing me new formulas. He is a brother of one of my coworkers. Really cool dude. And I got 2 different formulas that are, one's new to me. This is the Lip Tensity. See that dark navy blue? It is a gel-based lipstick. That is like no pressure. Like I didn't put any pressure on that. I bought the blue, not just because I do enjoy wearing blue lipstick, but I bought this to put under other lipsticks and to put under things like my Alchemist palette, because that blue with the ultraviolet tapped over the top of it becomes galaxy. And blue lipstick underneath your regular lipstick will make your teeth look whiter and your smile look bigger. And it's just a little photo illusion trick for when you're taking phenomenal selfies, just for the point of taking selfies. Selfie culture. Hashtag. The other one I bought because, as some of you may know, I have a hard-on for blue-brown pigments. MAC Blue Brown started one of my obsessions with duochromes. And now I'm going to give MAC all the credit, actually. MAC's Blue Brown Loose Pigment started my obsession with sparkly makeup. Because my mom's roommate, when I was in middle school, wore a lot of MAC. And she had an original pot of Blue Brown. And as soon as I played with it like once, and then I was in so much trouble because it's so expensive, and I was like 11, and I was like, put it all on my face. As soon as I used it, I was like, this is my life goal, is to be duochromed in everything. And MAC's On and On Frost Lipstick is blue brown pigment as a lipstick. And it's beautiful. Oh, and it's so soft, and it's not gritty at all. Like, I really actually was kind of concerned because for like $22, I thought it would be super gritty, and I also was concerned that it wasn't going to be a wearable color with that much blue pigment in it, and I had no reason to have any of those concerns. It was super amazing. It's beautiful. It feels good. It's a great color. I'm really happy with the purchase. And I'm not somebody who spends a lot of money on like super high-end stuff. Like this time I have more high-end stuff than I normally would because I drove significant amount of time out of my way to purchase high-end things. But normally I'm not a high-end person. But, you know, these are things that I'm glad that I bought. I'm going to get a lot of use out of them. This is something that I'm obsessed with. I'm going to get use out of it. The best way to look at a high-end product purchase if you're not entirely sure if it's the right thing for you is figure out how many times you think you're going to use it in the first month, so 30 days, and divide the cost of the product by that 30 days. So this palette was $32. In the first month, I'm probably going to use it 15 to 20 times. That means what I'm actually paying for it for usage-wise is I'm paying $2 a use, or maybe even less than that. I'm getting my money's worth out of this product. It's a good value. These MAC lipsticks are a good value because I'm going to use them a lot and have already used them a lot. And at least with these guys, they have a decent amount of product in them. So I feel okay about, you know, the cost of them and stuff like that. But if you get something and it's like, oh, it's really neat, I think I'm going to get that, but you don't think you're ever going to use it, just think about that cost. If you do have the money to do that, awesome. If you don't, turned. Trying to be positive. Stop it. Those are just things that you really want to like think about. Or you can buy trial sizes and try those first. So I bought about 3-4 weeks ago the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray in the trial size because I was like, oh, let's see if I like it. And I liked it so much I ended up buying Chill in the setting spray from them. It's their cooling and hydrating one. But I use it every day and I still have tons of product left. So it's worth my money. I'm making a good financial choice with that. Kind of like, you know, extraneous little things. Someone might think these little cat ear headbands are frivolous. I wear it every morning when I'm putting my makeup on and I think they're adorable and I got a pair for sparkles too. These are fun things, but they're things that can be practical if you're going to be wise about your spending. Never put yourself in the hole for something that's kind of a luxury. So just kind of be aware of that. Also, I have a few more things to go over with you before I leave. One, golden giveaway. You need to go to the video that says golden giveaway because I'm giving away stuff of the eyeshadow variety. It's a theme time this time. Eyeshadow, and the rules are really easy. And I want you to win things because I heard a bunch of people have already entered. That's awesome. I love that. I might even have to give away 2 people's worth of stuff. Another fun thing, I did a vlog. Some of you actually watched it. A surprising amount more people watched my vlog than I thought was going to watch my vlog. YouTube is reporting my views strange. On my YouTube like studio thing, it shows me a lot more views than if I click on the videos. But sometimes if I click on the video itself, it shows me a lot more views than the studio creator is showing me too. So I have an idea that a lot of you like me. And if you do, tell me, because that's really cool. And being told that, you know, people like you, especially when you feel as shitty as I do right now, helps. Glasses getting away from me. And tell me what you want to see. And, ooh, we've got some Valentine's Day stuff coming up. Are you excited? I'm excited. It's going to be amazing. So, hang out. Tell me what you like. Tell me if you want to see a specific product reviewed in something. And I guess I'll talk to you guys later.